Narito ang programang totoong totoo, Tambayan sa TWIZ. Programang magliliwanag ng ilang mahalagang mga issue. Tambayan, Tambayan sa TWIZ. At ngayon, narito na sila upang maghatid ng saya sa bawat Pilipino. Sa programang Tambayan sa TWIZ.
Magandang tanghali. Welcome to Tambayan. Kasama sa inyong pilan, Attorney Awesome Ahmed Paglinawa. Naku po si Trixie Cruz Angeles.
Hello.
And hello. Kung may mga, DWIZ text line 0999-376-6768. Ulitin po natin 0999-376-6768. We're also on Facebook Live and YouTube live streaming. Don't forget to like
memorize
and share.
Memorize tayo, mga ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Mag-like and share tayo.
Like and share. Lalong-lalo na dun sa mga nakapollow sa amin sa Luminous by Trixie Cruz Angeles and Ahmed Paglinawan. We have a Facebook page para sa mga nakikinig sa atin sa radyo. Mm-hmm. Hanapin lang po dun sa search bar Luminous, Luminous.
Meron ding YouTube.
Meron ding kami sa YouTube, Luminous by TCIAGP. So, same lang. Mga makikita niyo yung logo namin. Doon sa mga sumusubaybay doon sa page natin. Natin, actually. Kasi, masaya yung mga discussions doon. Lately, however, meron kaming kadiskusyon. And this is about charter change. You've heard the discussions dun sa kaninang umaga sa Karambola. If not, you can check out the replay. But we'd like to elaborate on some of the arguments, but also why we're doing this. Ngayon, may nagsasabi kasi na bakit natin kini-question itong pagsusulong ng pagbabago ng ating saligang batas.
Bakit hindi?
Okay. Marami yan eh. Maraming reasons. One of them is that masyadong na-demonize yung 1987 Constitution.
Which is, how can a piece of document be a demon?
Yeah, well, that's one. The second is kasi, while it is true that there are some provisions na kailangan natin ripasuhin.
Rephrase.
Or even take out entirely or readjust. We're not sure. Para, depende. What I mean is, depende yan sa sitwasyon at saka kung anong babaguhin.
And we won't know. Yung depende na yun, we will never know what it would depend on if we do not fight over these things. We have to discuss all of these things so that we will know kung saan magdidepende ang gagawin natin sa ating saligang batas.
Correct.
Importante yan.
So, when somebody tells you na masama yung 87 Constitution, that's being, not exactly truthful.
Kasi no, that is a lie. Yeah. That is completely wrong and dogmatic. How can a thing be bad? Bad and good are characteristics of human actions. Only only actions that were rooted in a will, okay, na ginusto mong gawin, at mind na nag-iisip, ang magiging masama o mabuti. Walang bagay na masama.
Because it is, ang good or bad is a result of certain choices.
They are characteristics, adjectives that relate to human actions.
There has to be a choice in there somewhere. So, bago tayo tumuloy, don't forget to like and share. Okay. Now, ganito kasi nag-umpisa yan, nag-live ako tungkol sa charter change. But that is because I read resolution of both houses number 2. And my discussion is primarily concerned with that.
Yung economic provisions, Beth?
Yung proposal itself. Kasi dun sa Article 12, which are the economic provisions, totoo nga, na matagal nang may diskusyon na yung ibang mga pagpipigil, kalimbawa, paglilimita sa foreign ownership.
Na siya reasonable. Hindi na siya naangkop sa panahon at sa
kailangan
demands.
Ripasuhin.
Exactly.
Sa mga kailangan nating gawin.
Yes.
Ripasuhin kasi hindi pa tayo sure kung ang problema ay nandito nga sa ating saligang basas.
O sa mga tao.
So, what is necessary is to pinpoint exactly what the problem is. Halimbawa, kahapon, nag-hearing ang Kongreso at ang pinresinta ay mga ekonomista na nagsasabing kailangan ng foreign direct investments. There's no question about that.
No,
kailangan! There, no man is an island. Di
because wala tayong pera on our own. Uh-huh.
However, I agree with that. The question is, kailangan bang baguhin ang mga provision sa ating saligang batas?
No.
And, kailangan ba yung pagkakagawa nito ay yung proposal na binibigay
isa
sa
lang ang proposal na palasubas. Okay, ang point is ganito.
Mm-hmm.
There is no question that we need an infusion of money. Mm-hmm. And the only way that we can do that is to get it from outside of our country.
Mm-hmm.
And that is foreign investment.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, if you are going to tell me that only foreign investment is our hope for this land, you are lying to me.
Mm-hmm.
And you're lying to the rest of the people in this country.
Uh-huh.
Because that is not the only way to achieve what you want.
Yun.
Second, is it completely impossible as the Constitution stands right now na mag-invest dito ang mga foreigners?
Hindi.
Definitely not. Mm-hmm. And if you are saying that it is, you are lying again.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And pangatlo.
Yeah. Pangatlo.
Masasabi mo ba na completely doon mo makoconcentrate ang problema dahil hindi natin pinapayagan ang foreign investment? Meron tayong foreign investment, okay? Meron silang will to come here. They want to come here and invest. Ano nangyayari? Ina-ambush sila nitong mga mayayaman dito sa Pilipinas, mga kapitalistang Pilipino, at sinasabi nila, hindi, mahirap dito. Mahirap mag-business dito. So we have to partner. Okay? When they partner with each other, hindi na may enjoy ng foreign funder, okay, ng finance, yung itong infusion ng pera, na may enjoy nila yung benefit sana ng full foreign na investment. Dahil itong mga Pilipino na mga oligarko na dati nang mayayaman dito at masyado nang gahaman sa pera, ay huhutakan sila ng gusto. At sa ganong paraan, hindi nakakapag-compete yung mga upstart, mga bagong businessmen, bagong mga consortium na imbis mabigyan sana ng chance to partner with these foreign investors, ay hindi. Dahil binabakura ng iilan, apat, lima na mga grupo ng mga gahaman at ganit ng mga oligarko.
One second. Short digression. Somebody is trying to make this appear that this is a Velasco-Cayetano issue. A, I don't like either one of them. B, okay, Alan Peter Cayetano was responsible for trying to railroad ABS-CBN. I have not forgotten that. So do not think for even one second that this is an opportunity for me to align with him. No. Because I am well aware of his past sins. He is still under investigation for the ASEAN Games. Do not, under any circumstances, politicize what we feel about the resolution of both houses number 2. And that is what the discussion is about. Mm. RBH 2, as being proposed by Congress to amend the Constitution.
On that note also, I am not beholden to the President. My allegiance is to this country. To the flag and to the people and to the laws of this country, not to any president. If this president is doing right, then I'll be joking with him. But if he is doing something wrong, he will be fucked by me.
We've always, and I just like to remind everybody that there are things that the president has said and done that we have opposed. Okay? So yung sasabihin yung dilaw yan kasi ayaw nilang ng ganito. Okay, kung pro Duterte sila, why are they doing this?
See if I care.
Yeah, one. Two, because it is wrong. Okay, and when we went to Malacanang in 2017,
We told him
that and he told us exactly the same thing. When I am wrong, you call me out.
So you're accusing me of being yellow, knock yourself out.
Diba?
I don't give a. Okay, so continue with that.
So, as we were saying, House Resolution number 2. So, yun yung mga issues that are being discussed.
That we want to discuss.
All of this is in the context. Lahat ito ay kailangan nakapatong tayo sa resolution. Dun sa House Resolution na hinahain nila. Bakit?
Ang ginagawa, pilit tayong nire-railroad, fina-flash-flood at nila-landslide papunta doon sa isyo nila na general statements. Na pagka meron kang konting disagreement o o puna ay antay ka na.
Oh.
Ang babaw naman yata. Mm. At saka, bakit hindi kami pwede magsalita?
Oh.
Ano ka, diktador?
Diba? So, the point here is that this was never a discussion about federalism or parliamentary or transforming us into one. Because sabi ng mga tao, cha-cha for FedPal.
Of course not.
That's not the discussion.
We are not talking about that.
Simple lang. Yung resolution of both houses number 2. Para sa mga nakikinig sa radyo, ang nakalagay dun sa RBH, dalawa yung basihan kung bakit nagpo-propose ng pagbabago sa saligang batas. Mm. At sinabi rin ni Speaker Alan Velasco,
Lord Alan
Velasco, kita mo nagkakabalibaliktad na pare-pareho kasi sila. Dahil ang dalawa ang dahilan at saka may mga clarifications siya. Unahin natin yung clarifications. One, that there will be no political changes in the Constitution.
So, wala nang FedPal.
Ibig sabihin,
walang
FedPal. And, walang pagtatanggal ng party list.
Oh, exactly.
Okay.
So,
dalawa.
So, babay na muna. According to this resolution, babay na muna ang FedPal.
Ngayon, bakit binabago ang saligang batas?
Shelved.
One, para mag-increase daw yung foreign direct investments.
Mm-hmm.
And two, para masagot ang COVID.
You want to put that in the Constitution?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
So yun. So given that, ngayon, ano yung mga nangyari bago yan? Kasi kailangan may konteksto din tayo. Kaya nga, nakakapagtaka yung mga taong nagsasabing, hala, anti-federalism kayo, when we haven't even talked about federalism yet.
Mm.
Ang usapang federalismo at parliamentary, kailangan, pinag-uusapan yan kapag may detalye na tayo.
Mm.
E kaso wala eh, puro proposal, FedPal, FedPal. Ang daming pumupunta sa atin, ang sabi, dapat federalism na tayo.
Bakit? Hindi masagot.
Hindi masagot.
Okay, ang FedPal is just a really small part of the Constitution.
Mm.
It is just the government part of the Constitution. Hindi magbabago ang, well, konti ang legislature, ang judiciary, and then executive.
Mm-hmm.
Pero, it's just really a small part. And if you think that you will rehash or throw away the entire Constitution just because you want to change into a federal parliamentary system of government, you are wrong.
Yeah. So, ang point dito is, may nakita ang mga tao, charter change. Akala nila, eto, pagkakataon na, isingit na natin yung mga kailangan natin. Meron pa dyan, abolish Congress. Agree naman ako dyan. Pero, tanggalin ang party list. Tanggalin ang,
Ang Bill of Rights.
Bill of Rights.
Imagine that.
Ay, sorry. Tanggalin ang Bill of Rights.
Okay.
Tanggalin ang, ano pa ba? Yun na nga. Tanggalin ang 60-40.
I-tax ang simbahan.
I-tax ang simbahan.
Oo, okay. I-defund ang UP.
So, sumabog ngayon yung diskusyon online. Some people were actually expecting na itong cha-cha ay magiging federalism. Hindi
of
po.
Of course not. There will be a lot of changes, but it need not be focused or only related to federalism and parliamentary. In fact, yan ang pinaka-list sa lahat ng nakapila ngayon na urgent na kailangan baguhin sa Constitution.
Mm-hmm.
Yan ang pinaka-list na i-consider ng ating Constituent Assembly. Yan ang pinaka-mababa sa priority. Bakit?
No.
Kasi we have more problems than our government and we can only do urgent actions that are limited, that we cannot answer all of these things in one fell swoop because it's impossible to do that.
Meron pang hirit. You know, I follow you. But I'm so disappointed that you don't want charter change. Okay,
idiot.
I'm sticking up my middle finger at you. Why?
And why do they have to say that?
Why did you conclude that?
Para makonsensya ka?
Diba? Parang,
what the
hawa ka naman.
Ano yan? Emotional blackmail so that we will side with your political opinion and opinion of a child?
Oo. So, ito yung point ng ano. So, yun yung konteksto. Ngayon, maraming tutol kayo sa charter change. I hate you.
Fine. See if I care.
Sige, like I care.
Okay, but right.
Ask me if I care.
All right.
So, yun na nga. Mm. Now, given that, ito yung konteksto ha. When we talk about charter change, ito lang ang pinag-uusapan natin.
Sa ngayon.
Yung proposal ng Kongreso.
Sa ngayon.
Right now. Alam mo kung bakit? Hindi nyo kasi pinapansin. Ang dami kasing diskusyon na dapat ganito, dapat ganyan. Okay, ang daming dapat. Pero in the meantime, dakdak kayo na nang dakdak diyan sa dapat ni railroad ng Kongreso itong mga pagnanakaw ng mga lupa natin. Diba?
Ito ang ginagawa nila, napapansin ko ha, on a baser level. Mm. In other words, when everyone the unwashed masses of this country, including me, nag-explain ako, nagsasabi ako dyan sa wall ko, and then may mga hirit doon, ganito kasi yan si Lenny Robredo, parang you do not take the discussion seriously, you don't read it, you just say bullshit that wouldn't help anyone. It wouldn't help my argument, it wouldn't help my way of communicating my argument to the opponent. And it wouldn't help the opponent clarify his goddamn ideas to me. You are just really a third party noise.
Yan.
And that is what's going on my wall and on Luminos and everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone is guilty of this.
Mm-hmm.
Such that when we want to focus on something, they think na nakikipag-away na tayo sa tao to the point na magpataya na tayo. Of course not. I wouldn't want to kill any of them. I mean, they don't deserve my time and my freedom.
Mm-hmm.
Diba? Parang dipong, I can just really leave you alone and see you fail.
Mm-hmm.
But I have to explain this because I am a lawyer and I took an oath to support the Constitution, Jesus Christ. If you are asking me why I am noisy about these things, because it is my job.
Mm-hmm.
It is my job to do this. When the Constitution and the laws of this country...
Tayong lahat. It's our obligation.
No, actually, it's our profession's obligation. Also, tayong dalawa.
Okay. So, hindi. In addition to this, the danger isn't yung inaaway kami. di ba? Please, I've had worthy opponents before. This is not one of them.
We had so, dangerous opponents before.
Yeah, hindi naman ito yung first time na babarilin ako, if ever.
Sinong babaril dito sa atin? Hello?
But the point is this.
NPA lang.
When you talk about yung mga dapat, you have taken the discussion away from the more pressing need and danger. And I would like to emphasize this. There is an imminent danger to all of us.
Mm.
Okay? Ngayon, para hindi halata na, oops, out of
guguluhin
topic pa sila na
nagguguluhin
sila.
Ang usapan.
Ngayon, yung sinasabi nila, dati sabi nila, hindi, talagang ayaw naman namin palitan yung provisions of ownership.
Ngayon, napansin ko kahapon, ABS-CBN, dinala sa ABS-CBN yung discussion.
Yeah.
When it was the economic provisions, suddenly ABS-CBN issue to. Mm. Nice try, dudes.
Diba?
At hindi. Itong mga...
It is. Okay? It is.
Well,
we also brought it up.
Yes, but kasi, that's not what it is.
No, it's not. It's not.
All
it's
in
the
all.
Danger to the Constitution.
Okay, bakit?
The ABS-CBN is an effect of this.
Okay, we already discussed yesterday about freedom of ownership, of private ownership of property, and who owns the territory of this country.
Mm-hmm.
Next, if you fiddle with the government, especially with Congress, you will upset the balance of power of the three bodies of government.
Yan.
If you give more power to Congress without giving equivalent and controlling power to the other two, you are an idiot.
Okay.
You will destroy that balance.
Ito yung argumento ng kabila, ng mga nag-a-attack sa atin. Kailangan baguhin yung Constitution.
Mm-hmm.
Kailangan pasok yung FDI na yan.
Mm-hmm.
Tanggalin yung 60-40.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi that will help sa FedPARL.
How?
Let the states decide. Sabi. But there are no states.
There are no states.
There is no FedPARL.
Dude.
Well, they are changing the constitution
now.
But keeping everything intact. In this kind of institution, in this kind of government, no other changes are being proposed and no other changes are going to be expected. No other do you honestly think that the next president, even if it is Sara Duterte who actually said na mahirap yung FedPAR ngayon,
mahirap talaga.
We will keep talking about it.
These people are living in a fantasy land. I mean, naniniwala na nga ako eh. I was slowly, until now, I am still convinced that this is a good thing, that we will try this federal parliamentary.
Yeah.
But if this is the, be all of everything, you are living with Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
I don't want to discuss it because the way people are looking at FedPAR right now,
it's fantasy.
It's like it's the answer to all our problems.
It's unicorns and rainbow bright.
And the problem is that we keep holding on to that fantasy or that dream or that goal. Fine, hold on to that, but we have real problems right now.
Imminent.
And one of them is that Congress is going to give away things like our national parks. Okay,
and they will become very, very powerful as to own the territory of this country, and there is no balancing, controlling power given to the executive and the judiciary. And if you understand your government principles and political philosophy, you will know this. If you didn't ever think of these things,
I don't even know
what the hell are you doing there. What the hell are you doing in the helm, at the helm of all these movements, if you are as ignorant as that? Sige, larga.
Okay.
Sagot.
So, the danger right now is everybody is trying to distract us from the real battle. The real battle right now is if you've read resolution of both houses number two, the giveaways are mind-boggling. And they are hidden in an innocuous statement that says,
unless otherwise provided by law. It's just a proviso, and it will change the scheme of things that is fundamental to democracy and a republican government. If you want your federal parliamentary sometime in the future, you do not do this thing. Because after this, there is no more democracy and there is no more room for federal parliamentary. This is now, again, a feudal system where there are many, many princes as a barcada, and that is the Congress. And the executive cannot control them because they own even the land of the executive. They own even the houses of the justices of the Supreme Court. So, why would anybody want to do this if they are really honestly concerned for the economic welfare of this country? Why would you sell it like that?
Okay, now another thing. You seem to think that so many problems will be solved by the Constitution, by the change in the Constitution, and that it is the Constitution's wordings or clauses, the principles, the doctrines that have led us to where we are. First of all, look at where we are. Bakit pinag-uusapan ng foreign direct investments when the president's administration, this administration, has posted the highest ever foreign direct investments of any president ever. Okay?
Tapos sasabihin niyo that we need more. And then you blame it on the Constitution.
Yeah.
Are you insane? Do you really honestly still live in this fantasy world where the Constitution is the magic abracadabra that once you find it, your problems are solved?
Looking for single solutions to every problem that we have.
FedPAR
is not going to answer everything. The change in the Constitution is not going to answer everything. And also, we need to be more precise about what is the answer to all of this. What is the first problem? The first problem that I see is that Congress is so powerful, nobody can take them out, nobody can remove a member. They get a say in who the president chooses as his cabinet. They get a say in the budget of the national government.
Get
to ignore us if we want changes in laws.
Tapos gusto niyong bigyan ng dagdag na power yung mga yan?
Oh.
Are you insane?
Diba?
What you want is to lessen the power of the very powerful body of government. And that is Congress. And give more freedom to the people and give more incentive to the other bodies of government that support and enable freedom, diba? And democracy. Hindi sa paggawa ng batas at pagnakaw ng lupa ng taong bayan at pagbenta nito kung kailan nila gusto. Hindi kayo nag-iisip eh.
So ito yung nangyayari ngayon. We have this really dangerous situation. We have people who have decided, by saying, unless otherwise provided by law, Congress now gets to say na, oh, I don't like that. Wow! Ang daming lupa dito! Ay, national park ba siya? Di pali, gawa tayo naman.
Tapos sasabihin nyo, to control that, is that we have to trust our office. If you trust these people, why do you want to change the constitution? Why don't you just trust them that they will allow foreign funders who can already invest in this country despite the limits in the constitution? Bakit wala silang ginagawa tungkol dyan? Why do they still allow big oligarch companies in the Philippines like ABS-CBN to subsist?
Diba? Magbabalikan tambayan ang oras natin, 12:31 ng tanghali.
Tambayan sa DWIZ. DWIZ. Muli nating balikan. Tambayan sa DWIZ.
Balikan tambayan, kasama pa rin sa impila na Attorney Osam Ahmed Paglinawan at Pusik-Pix Cruz Angeles. And we're still talking about charter change. Ngayon, ano, and we have talked about the context. So again, people are asking us, what can we do? Well, first of all, yung mga bullies on social media who kapag nagpresenta ka ng ibang argumento o kaya ibang opinion, kinukuyog ka, simple lang yan. First of all, don't engage. Kasi lalong-lalo na kung super tanga yung statement nila, it's not gonna fly. Okay? It's senseless to engage.
Ako, ang ginagawa ko when this group sends their minions to me, I hit their leader.
Yes.
Over and over and over again.
Hit only one and one person.
I don't know all these idiots who they come to my wall, but I know their leader. I will I will wash you and rinse you until you get the sense to tell your ignorant people to get some information inside of their heads.
So what we need to do is keep reiterating the same message. Don't engage. Alam niyo kung bakit? All we have to do is get the word out. If ang purpose ay COVID at FDI,
they don't need.
Unang-una, ano lang ba ang 60-40? Kasi sinasabi na lahat, tanggalin na yan 60-40. Bakit 60-40 lang? Kasi 100% everybody agrees with that. Okay?
Bakit pinipilit itong 60-40? Bakit ito ang apple of the eye nitong mga to? Kasi nandyan ang mass media.
Yan! So there we go.
Ang telecoms.
Rappler, ABS-CBN. Now it's an issue. Telecoms.
Nakikita nyo? At saka, itong pagbibigay na itong nag-iiba yung power sa Kongreso such that they actually now will own the territory of this country, hindi nyo ba nakoconnect yan sa binasa ng Pangulo ng mga pangalan ng congressman involved in corruption? Isn't this just the retaliation? Gago tong presidente na to. Kinakanti tayo ha. Okay, i-amend natin ang constitution, give ourselves more and more power such that we actually own this country, and we'll see what happens. Let this guy and his group deceive the people, and let the people vote in the referendum for the amendment that they propose.
So don't engage.
Not gonna happen.
The sycophants. They're interested only in what they want to appear in the Constitution. They're not interested in Congress na binabalahura na tayo. Wala silang pakialam dyan.
Kasi as long as they think dyan.
That, tama yan. Yan yung isa sa agenda natin. Matatapos na, magagawa na. No! They're not even getting that because that's not what the proposal is. The proposal doesn't say, tatanggalin natin ang 60-40.
siningitan lang
tignan
na isang maliit.
Tignan ninyo yung proposal. May nakalagay bang ganun?
Ngayon. Why do you suddenly limit your care, okay, your concern, to all of these, to these few things, okay, when, and you completely ignore what will happen to your freedom as Filipinos? Because if I were you, I would be worried first about what this little stupid circus that they propose to do, what will be its effect on my freedom and security of my future children and family and their future children and family. Yan ang uunahin ko. Bakit? Kasi yan ang real. Yan ang reality. Yan ang totoo. Yan ang praktikal. Kung makikipag-debate ka sa amin tungkol sa pag-word ng mga provision ng Constitution, knock yourself out. Because we studied that and we can do that while sleeping. But, do you even discuss, do you even see, okay, much more discuss, what will happen to your democracy? What will, do you even have the right to economic development after this happens? Eh, isipin nyo mabuti yan dahil magagaling kayo dito sa pakikipagmuranin. I don't mind na murahin ako kasi gawain ko yan eh. But if you're a moron, do not you know, insist that I listen to your moronism because you can't even traverse my argument. You can't even answer it. You can't even debunk it.
Okay.
Diba? Puro ka na lang, dilaw yan, diba? Whatever.
Ito, sabi ni Attorney Tom Berenguer, more than the constitutional limitations on equity, what turns off foreign investors is the lack of infrastructure, high taxes, and high labor costs.
There you go.
Okay? But we're not addressing that.
At saka yung ano, yung overhead ng kuryente, tubig, all of these all of these things that are needed in the day-to-day running of a business. So, do you find that in the Constitution? Or is it just in the implementation of the Constitution's imposition of duty on Congress na i-implement nyo ng maayos ang welfare ng taong bayan by making laws that will mean something to the freedom of the human beings in this country and not to the companies that are getting richer and richer every single time because you are making more franchise laws than anything else in Congress.
So, yun. The other issue is what the problems that are being sought to be addressed here obviously clearly are wrong. Okay, una yung foreign direct investments are an all-time high, number one. And it isn't the lack of foreign direct investments that have led to OFWs.
Kasi it was a program
nila. Kaya sinasabi nung isang matagal na akong OFW.
Kaya brain drain daw.
Kaya daw siya naging ganon dahil walang trabaho.
Hindi.
Dito.
Wait. Sinadyayan.
Ano yung mga reasons bakit walang trabaho dito? Nakakapit yung oligarchs, sila lang ngayong pagtayo ng negosyo. Why? Because money makes more money.
Sila lang ang nakaka-compete. Yung mga maliliit na tao, hindi umuunlad. Okay, at magkatrabaho sila, ang liliit ng sweldo nila, napipilitan silang umalis.
Ito, sabi ni Jemshid Mumar, another problem for against foreign direct investments is internet.
Exactly.
Correct,
yung mga overhead.
Diba? Infrastructure talaga. How can we make this a better business climate for foreign direct investors? Why are we changing the constitution when we haven't even cleaned up our house?
Meron pa. Culture of science and technology. Because we are afraid of math and science and technology.
We have been made afraid.
Ang ating mga matatalino ay kinukuha ng McAfee, kinukuha ng Norton, kinukuha ng magagaling na mga kumpanya sa Amerika. Bakit? Kasi we do not give them opportunity to develop, to do their thing here, and develop. So, ano yan? Do you think that is just the dysfunction of this government and this constitution? Or was it the plan of the few people that hold this country at hostage? Na gusto nilang panatilihin tayong ganyan kahirap at walang makitang trabaho sa Pilipinas para magsialis na lang tayo at hindi na tayo magkaroon ng sarili nating pag-unlad dito sa ating bansa, at sila-sila na lang ang nandito, nakaupo dito at kumakamada ng pera dahil hindi tayo nakakompete.
There are two reasons. There are many reasons. Pero two of those reasons kung bakit in-encourage ang OFWs. It began with the oil crisis of 1974. So wala tayong pera, wala tayong leverage. Nag-start yung nag-export tayo ng mga kontratista to the Middle East.
Middle East and dito sa Southeast, sa Indonesia, Malaysia, Singapore.
To negotiate for fuel. Tapos, dahil malaki ang bayad abroad, maraming nainganyo.
Nawili.
Nung maraming nainganyo, the government decided to make a program out of it because it addressed two things. One, kasi may labor unrest dito at the time. Remember, namamayagpag ang KMU. Ang daming nagsara ng mga pabrika. Encouraged also by the people we later called yellows. Bakit? They needed the unrest so that they could oust Marcos. Okay, another. They also needed to address what was at the time an exploding population. But because hindi like any other politician at the time takot sa simbahan, rather than promote
condom,
Marcos did
control.
Put in popcom, ha? Meron tayong population commission. And meron din tayong programa for contraceptives,
which was nullified by the church,
constantly undermined by the church. But with a burgeoning population and work becoming more scarce, and then favored oligarchs na namamayagpag without any kind of competition, sending people abroad was an answer.
That is the only way to make this life feel like it's still life. So anong ibig sabihin yan? Kasi bakit yung mga oligarchs na yan didn't in their good hearts and their so many monies build industries here?
Why that? Iba, why
bakit hindi nila hinire yung mga yan?
One of the reasons at the time kung bakit hindi nag-i-industrialize was because so many of our oligarchs and old rich families
owned the lands.
They had agricultural lands.
Tubo. Dyan sa Tarlac, dyan sa Negros.
Kamusta naman? Sino yun? Tubo? Sugar?
Tubo.
Sino yun? Okay, yan. Sige. They had large agricultural estates.
Ayaw nilang mag-industrialize.
So, imbis na mag-industrialize, dun sila. At dito. Nagpapakahirap.
We will keep you poor and buying from us.
Absentee landlords sila. Okay? Nag-introduce si Marcos ng agrarian reform. Ayan na, nag-umpisa na yung
pinapunta niya sa Mindanao ang mga taga-Ilocos.
Nagpapunta din, not just Ilocanos, ha?
Pero marami sa amin, ang daming Ilocano na dumating doon.
Correct.
To occupy southern Mindanao.
So, yun.
Ang saya.
So, these were, the export of, when that started, pati lahat nag-adjust, including the educational system. We had to get workers ready for abroad. But only for that. And since yung mga hinahire abroad were either manual labor
umuunlad.
At the start, ha? Hindi pa ito brain drain. Later
pa.
On, dumating
ito,
yung brain drain.
Ito mga talaga to, mga peon talaga to sila. Tagapala, tagapiko, hakot ng graba.
So yan. Now, imagine yung scenario at the time. So it was an answer to our prayers. Ngayon,
it's a revolution. Cory Aquino.
Foreign direct investors had newfound confidence in the new Aquino government. Ang daming pumasok dito. Pero, nadagdagan ba yung labor market natin?
Ganun pa rin.
Hindi. Kinamada kasi ng mga oligarchs. They would partner with
sila pa rin. Mga Soriano, mga Cojuangco. Sila yung mayayaman at
correct.
That time.
Oo. So, what they did was they increased the readiness to export labor. By readiness, this was not a good thing.
They actually made a program out of it.
Binawasan ang number of hours of school kasi syempre kung matalino tayo masyado,
makamaging
mga professionals, magkaroon ng sariling negosyo dito.
Kaya technical schools.
Yun ang ayaw ng mga oligarchs. Competition coming from here. Kasi yung foreign, pwede nilang kamanahin.
Pwede nilang i-hijack yan, utuin yan, at makipag-partner sa kanila, Nakawa na naman nila. And that is what they do to every foreign investor.
So yun yung ano, yun, the what is the problem? The first problem of all of this is a Congress that had gotten too powerful because it is fueled by oligarchy. And two, corruption.
Oh, at ang mga tao ay complacent. So ano ang on a theoretical level, ano ito? Saan to sa mapa ng demokrasya? This is the part where in the definition of democracy says redistribution of power and wealth to the majority, if not all, of the people in that country. Redistribution. Dahil ang ating kongreso ay hindi nila na enable itong redistribution na ito dahil hindi nila na control itong oligarchs at imbis na i-redistribute yung yaman sa ibang mga tao, na focus na sa kanilang lahat at na funnel na sa kanila lang at sa kanila lang lagi. Hindi po yan problema ng constitution. Nasa tangayan ng mga congressman, tanga ng mga tao na bumoto sa kanila at kayo. Yan yun.
Ano pa? NPA. Okay, huwag nating kakalimutan yung NPA. Why? They prevent development in the areas. Magkakaroon ba tayo ng foreign direct investment dun sa mga areas na yon? Wala nga tayong local investment sa areas na yon eh. Dahil sa insurgency. No, dahil nanununog sila ng equipment.
Namamaril.
Kidnap. Kidnap for her. But of course, it's not just the NPA. Dun sa ibang mga areas, it's the ASG.
ASG.
Diba? O yung mga secessionist movements. Kaya ako kahit kailan noon, ubusin yan talaga.
So, hey, para sa akin, kasi, these are the internal problems of the Philippines that does not impinge on the relationship between the government, the state, and the constitution. It has nothing to do with that. It just has something to do with the willingness and the willpower, okay, the political will of the bodies of government to do its job. Hindi lang talaga sila gumagawa dahil oligarchs, ano bang alam ang gawin ng mga yan? Kundi ang magkape at magpaplansya ng mga magaganda magagarang damit, mamasyal-masyal dyan sa Makati magkape. Nothing for the poor people, nothing to make the people competitive so that they can compete with their former bosses.
Diba?
Wala,
nobody
hindi ganyan.
Somebody to be able to compete with them. So yun, ang daming problema. Now, naging presidente si Duterte, nakita niya yung mga problema. What did he first do? Free tertiary education. Para nababawasan yung burden natin sa pagpapaaral ng mga anak. And that's supposed to be a growing program. Ibig sabihin, kung meron kang libreng grade school, high school, college, there will be more and more institutions with free tertiary education. More money must be made to fuel that so we don't have to send kids abroad anymore.
To work as what?
Diba?
Yan nga.
Tayo na mag-hire ng foreign labor. In the 1600s, sorry, it's a history lesson. In the 1600s, alam mo kung sino yung imported labor natin? Tayo yung boss. Tapos yung mga ama o aya, and that's where we get the term yaya, were Chinese. Kasi hirap na hirap ang inchik noon sa China. So, they would send their poor here to work. And some of them were artisans. After a while, hindi na rin kaya na buhayin lahat ng mga artisans sa China, lalo na sa Fujian province. Dito yung mga carvers natin, artisans
pottery
natin, dito natin pinadala. So if you will see yung mga 17th century icons carved in ivory, singkit. Kasi yung artisans, mga inchik. So, and we were the superpower.
And it has nothing to do with the constitution. It has been here, the problem has been here before the 1987 constitution, before the 1973 constitution, and even before the 1935 constitution. Why? Because we are a people that were imposed with a democracy that we did not develop.
Okay.
That we are supposed to follow the rules of democracy of America. We are supposed to benefit from the benefits of the democracy of America, except that we are not America. We have an entirely different culture. We have an entirely different people with different values and even different wants and needs and ambitions.
Mm-hmm.
Hindi naman natin balak na magkaroon ng picket fence and two cars, which is the life, well, di ba?
That's the U.S. standard.
Oh, that's the standard. Hindi yan ang standard natin. So, how can we ever be as nice and as well off as the Americans with our democracy when it is not even our own?
Uh-oh.
And now you want to fiddle with what small democracy we have by playing around with the Constitution.
Mm-hmm. So, this is how to handle the social media outbreak or the backlash of this. Because, of course, hindi naman natin iniisip na merong kumukumpas sa likod ng mga ito. Some of them are true believers. Some of them are not.
Some of them
might be funded.
Are just really lost people.
Some of them are lost. Pero, hindi kasi sila nag-a-argue within the context of RBH2. Simple lang. Tinailihis nila yung diskusyon.
Hirap patani doon sa madali na sabi sa mga tao para malinlang.
Diba?
Oo, sasabihin nila, imbis na sagutin na argumento, hindi, dilaw yan si Ahmed.
Yan, imbis na ganyan. Or I'm so disappointed in you. Excuse
Dude.
Me, I'm not even out to impress you. So I don't really give a flying F. Now,
really?
How do we get this? How do we get the message out? Because you know what? I strongly suspect that the president knows, but he's not able to do anything about it. Kaya nga sinabi niya eh. Mm. Diba? Hindi coincidence. Mm. Na before this happened, nagbasa ang presidente ng listahan ng allegedly suspected to be corrupt politicians, mga congressista.
And suddenly, there's a proposal to empower the Congress more. Hindi niyo nakikita ang relasyon niyan and suddenly ikaw na ngayon ang nagsusulong ng ganyan. So,
di ba?
Ginagamit ka ba o ano? Siguro maganda suriin mo ang sarili mo. Suriin mo ang mga kumukumpas sa galaw mo kasi baka sobrang ignorante ka. Ikaw na 'yung nagbigay sa atin sa bibig ng buhaya.
So, ang point dito is the discussions online or even dito sa nakita ko yung may poll eh. So, ang ginagawa, they will poll you. They will poll us.
Well, but I ignore
all
it.
All you have to do is ignore
the
them.
Leader.
Do not give them a platform. Do not give them anything. So, but you just stick to like share yung sa Luminous.
And participate. Say
comment.
Something that is meaningful.
Something, or...
Huwag yung, gago kasi yan siya ganito eh, dahil kamag-anak kasi yan ni ganito. Pakialam ko sa mga yan, kahit na anak pa yan ni Satanas or whatever.
It's not about the person. It's about the fact that they're not seeing what we're seeing.
And honestly, really, I think that by the way they talk and argue, they really are idiots unless they prove it otherwise.
And... as much as possible on this matter, normally hindi ako galit eh, pero I am angry about this.
Why?
I'm angry at the at deception, at the doublespeak, and that people are trying to stop us from talking about this. Oh. How do they stop us? They call Ahmed yellow, they say they're disappointed
and mock the fact that I would cite theorists of law and jurisprudence and they actually enjoy it and para sa akin pero ito ganito ha, bakit tayo hindi maging passionate about this when this is our constitution we are talking about?
We have
this
to
is
be
our
passionate.
Freedom
we
this
have
is
to
our
argue.
Country
we have to talk about it. If we talk angrily, it's because we are angry.
If you are ever going to argue publicly about anything passionately, this is it.
And
nothing
under,
else.
And under no circumstances do you interrupt that by saying ang puso mo. Because that's what we're doing.
Ayan, idiocy yan. Yan yung yan yung sinasabi ko. Yung nagpapa-dilute ng meaning ng nangyayari. I just ignore those people and hope that they just choke on their sleep.
By the way, it's not true that these people are being listened to by the president.
Of course not.
Kasi sinabi na nga ng Pangulo, hindi kaya mag-fed. Not at this time.
Misrepresentation yan. Tawa na lang ako dyan magsinasabi. And then you actually parang,
Hello, si Amel, si Trixie, lumalaban sa, ah, nagsusumbong ka sa presidente. Do you think the president, if he really thinks the way you do, cannot do anything about the two of us, really? Ang talino mo naman.
Oh.
Really?
For our part, we will keep talking. We will keep talking about this. So yung live kahapon with Ahmed and JP and myself, we'll have a part 2 and 3 and 4. So we will discuss every single provision the Congress wants to change.
Yep.
Okay?
So, and, stop us. Try it.
And ano, we just want you to join us. Join us for the ride. Join us for the
asaran.
For the asaran. For the humor of
okay
it.
Naman yung,
what we can pick up.
Okay naman yung ad hominem eh. Basta hindi lang ad hominem lahat ang sasabihin mo.
Oo, hindi pwedeng.
Have some brain and spicy rapid ad hominem. It makes the discourse lively and happy and make you feel like sometimes you win and sometimes you lose. It's all right.
So, magpapasalamat rin ako sa inyong lahat for joining us in this discussion, for being part of Luminous, and parami tayo, let's have more people na nakatambay sa Luminous. Maraming salamat sa pagsubaybay sa tambayan itong araw na ito. Mga taga-YouTube, mga taga-Facebook, we see your comments, sorry we can't answer all of them, pero maraming salamat for joining us. Antawayan ang susunod na programa in the Heart of Business, kasama si Ma'am Marupa Hatisani at Mr. Lito Gagni. We'll see you tomorrow on Karambola. Ako po si Trixie Cruz Angeles.
Tambayan sa DWIZ.